When it comes to manufacturing, bottlenecks are a well-known phenomenon that every industry has to deal with. While engineers are trying to anticipate and avoid bottlenecks when designing production lines, they often end up discovering new ones as things don't always go as expected in production, or as specifications may change subsequently. Today, I'm going to show you 5 things that could cause a bottleneck on a production line. This doesn't aim to be an exhaustive list of everything that could go wrong when it comes to material flow, but rather a couple examples of things we might want to anticipate. Let's start with the first one, and probably the most obvious one. Production lines are manufacturing parts at a certain pace, which is usually the cycle time of the slowest operation of the line. Every other operation, both upstream or downstream ones, has to adapt to this cycle time so that parts do not indefinitely accumulate at the slowest operation, and so that downstream operations do not experience short stops waiting for parts to come in. In case an operation can't be synchronized with the slowest one, using inventories as buffers can help to fluidize the stream. The slowest operation is called the bottleneck as it is the one that limits the production capacity of the whole line. Another thing that might cause trouble to the material flow is the mutualization of operations for different products. While mutualization of operations is usually a good way to optimize costs of production, manufacturers have to make sure those operations are able to handle the additional workload in order to not become the bottleneck for the whole process. Here we can observe multiple paths providing parts to a single downstream path. This single downstream path is visibly not able to handle the workload and parts are accumulating at that specific place. Here too, the bottleneck limits the production capacity of the whole line. Another thing that could disrupt a production flow is an interdependence between multiple processes. If a process has to wait for another one to finish before starting, it depends on it. The dependency might be caused by a shared resource. For example, an employee might be asked to operate alternatively on 2 workstations. Thus, each workstation has to wait for the employee to come back in order to proceed. Here we see that the first process has to stop while the second one is busy. This causes parts to accumulate and creates a bottleneck. This kind of bottleneck might be hard to spot as there might be a lot of interdependencies between operations on complex production lines. Every production line requires items to be supplied, either components to be integrated on the product, or consumables needed for specific operations. The supply has to be secured in order to avoid shortages that could stop the production for long periods of time. If the component is repeatedly unavailable for short periods, it could cause short stops to a workstation. Parts could then accumulate at said workstation, repeatedly waiting for components to be supplied and becoming the bottleneck of the whole line. To avoid such misadventure, a strategy must be adopted to ensure components are always available. Kanbans and other inventory management systems are here to help. Inefficient transportation may also be something that generates bottlenecks. The transportation solution has to be wisely chosen considering the weight, the size, the fragility, and the number of products to be carried. The number of needed transporters depends not only on travel time but also on loading and unloading durations. In the example we have here, we see that the transportation is not suited for the throughput of the line. A solution that comes to mind might be to load incoming parts on a palletizer and transport them in batches. By transporting in batches, we mutualize travel time but we add loading and unloading operations on the line, which are operations that don't add any value to the product. Operations without added value are usually something we want to avoid, so transporting in batches is not always the best solution for this problem. With these few examples, we understand that a bottleneck may have very different root causes. Do you have in mind any other thing that could possibly cause a bottleneck? Or did you experience a bottleneck that was totally unexpected at your factory? Please let us know by sharing your thoughts in the comments section. I will be happy to answer it. On a final note, I would like to tell you a little bit about VisuFact, which is a factory flow simulator currently under development that can be used to identify bottlenecks on a production line. I used the demo version to make the animations of this video. A beta version will be available later this year. Make sure to subscribe on visufact.com to get your free access. Thanks for watching the video and have a wonderful day.